Hey everybody, this is a general look back at and summary of the creatures, the companions to the Toa for the LEGO Bionicle 2016 season. We got the creature of fire, who's extremely bright and colorful and has those nice fiery wings that you could repose a bit in some different ways. Has a very obvious tail, has a bird-like thing going here, and its action feature was actually quite nice with the flapping wings, and you could change the angles of those wings, just the static angles of them, to make the, you know, just give it kind of different looks to how it was flying and what exactly it was doing. So that actually worked out pretty nicely, and this was a major way to do it like this. Move the legs back and get the wings forward like that, and then you get the up and down motion, which is really nice. This one was done pretty perfectly, especially for its parts count, I'd say. Melum is from a very icy cold place, but ironically he's very warm and affectionate inside, just going around just wanting to give hugs to everybody. As a build, aside from the personality that you can put in this one, this one did let me down quite a bit because it came with such a large set and yet ended up being one of the smaller and less interesting looking builds with, you know, less stuff on it, and just the overall size is just in a much more compact package. It's fine for what it is, but I really did expect more from the bigger set. The Creature of Earth was all about getting the crowd hyped up, and I like this one. The action feature is not that great. I mean, it's supposed to be kind of a scratching, digging, swinging fists and claws kind of thing, but most of the time it's not even able to reach past its own nose. But I think it looks nice. I like the colors here, and it kind of stands out from the rest. I feel like this is a better thing to do with this type of build with the big paws than Melum was. The Creature of Water is absolutely unique and comes with a stand, which I found to be just fantastic. It works great for display, and this just has a nice look to it. It's kind of shark inspired, I'd say, or fish you could say. The color scheme actually works out pretty well. I think the colors actually work better on this than on the Toa this one was intended to go with. The articulation is nice with the ball joints, two ball joints in the tail to allow this to move around. It's able to shoot unlike all the rest, which, you know, it's fine. You can go either way on that, but this feature is really nice. It's only used for the Unity combination, really, but it's integrated in there very nicely and smoothly. It works well, and you can also change the angles of these shooters. You can bring that down a little bit more low profile for this mode. This is a good one. When all is said and done, the Creature of Jungle ended up being my favorite, but that's just a personal opinion. I like the color scheme. I like the spread of the wings, and, you know, this is a great example of just how much larger and how much more presence you get out of some of these compared to a little dude like this, you know, supposed to be kind of appear at the same level. The action feature here is just like with the Creature of Fire, but I feel like it moves a little bit more air, and you can also individually move these parts of the wings there in addition to kind of bending them if you want. You can do something like that, you know, change it up, change things up a bit. And it just has a nice personality to it with the shapes of the legs and kind of having no apparent hands or anything. I like this one a lot. Finally, the Creature of Stone takes a little bit of influence from a scorpioid type of design with the stinger tail back there, and it has an interesting action feature with the crystal blades at the end. This is useful for play, for sure. Once again, you can change the angles of these things so you can make it look a little bit different, like it's fighting a little bit more to the side or like it's fighting more above it. You know, change things up a bit and you get full articulation with the legs. You can change the angle of it, kind of angle the thing back more very, very easily, you know, so that it's looking like it's attacking something that's much larger than it. I personally don't favor the color scheme on this one, nor its build, but I think that it is well done. You know, I think that it makes for a good toy. Now, sticking with the Earth element, you know, in 2015, for the smaller sets, we got the Protectors, and now we've got Creatures. Very, very different. You know, the protectors were very humanoid, which has a certain level of familiarity with it. And I think that the protectors were actually really good for kids who actually had to pay for their own toys with their own saved up money, because the protector could easily be used as a stand-in, as a proxy for a Toa or for some sort of villain. I personally tend to prefer the creatures because they're just more imaginative to me. They're more different, and I think it's just good to get more animal-like things into these imaginary universes. You know, the Toa already are humanoid enough themselves, as are many of the villains. So I think the creatures just really change things up. Plus, from past generations of Bionicle, I personally tended to really favor the Rahi, which were the animals, you know, what they were called in general. And yeah, I think that it's great that they're continuing that legacy on. And I think that they've come up with a nice variety of them with just these relatively small sets this year. And five of the creatures do each include one of these shadow traps, and they have very slightly different designs. And in my reviews of each creature, I expressed very clearly my lack of excitement over these things in general. They're just, I don't know, they just don't interest me personally, and there's not a lot of difference between them. I kind of do like the jungle one because of its legs. It looks like it could be kind of slithering along and growing along as it moves. And then also the one that came with the creature of water was very interesting to me because it's so much larger, has so much more presence. This actually kind of looks scary to me compared to these smaller ones that just, you know, they have little legs and just feels like you could easily just step on them. The feature that they have of actually being able to trap things is fine, but then what happens? It's not like they're going to eat you or infect you or anything like that. Just with their physical design, you know, just doesn't interest me personally, and that's just my personal opinion, and nothing is going to change that because their designs are done the way that they're done. I do like what they did with the Shadow Trap parts on Umarak the Hunter, how they actually integrate in. So I think that these are definitely useful parts that can be put to good use, you know, combined with other things. But compared to the Skull Spiders from the previous year, I feel like at least those seemed more like they could be venomous, plus you could also use their bodies as actual masks to change to a different character. Overall, I'm very happy to have gotten this series of creatures this year. I'm glad that we got the protectors also. I think that they both have their place, and I wouldn't mind getting more protector-like things in the future. Again, I think that they are really good for folks on a budget who are not able to buy all the Toa that they want, or who just want to get more individual characters for the same amount of money compared to just, you know, spending on Toa. Let me know in a comment what you think about this series of creatures and how you think they compare to the protectors. Do you have a favorite between the two? Which would you like to see more of in the future? Thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for more.